Hey guys, what's up? Today we're going to be looking at the intro to Cliffs of Dover. It's quite ridiculous, be warned. Guys, let's have a look at the first little chunk. Slow that down. I've got an open note on the sixth string. I'm doing a big bend on 15 of the first. And then I want to play it down. So after that, I want to go 12, 14 on the first string. And then I go to 15 of the second. And I've got a flat finger on the first two strings. So I'm going 12 of the first and then 12 of the second. And then I end that with a big bend on 15 of the second string. So all together. Okay, then we follow it up with this pretty insane pentatonic E run. All right, let's slow that down. I'm gonna start off with 12 of the first string. And I do a pull off from 15 to 12 on the second. And I do a slight bend on 14 of the third string. And then I go 12, 15 on the second string. So it goes. So I do a pull off on the way back. Sorry, pull off on the way up. And then on the way back, I pick both the notes. So I'll play that a bit slower. Okay, and then from there I go. I play 12 of the first string. And I go 15, 14, 12, and then 15 of the string above. And then I go 14, 12, and then 15 of the string above. So I'll play that slowly. So all together. Okay, then after that I go. I do a hammer-on from 12 to 15 on the second string. Then hit 12 of the first. And then a pull-off from 15 to 12 on the second. So it'll go. Okay, and then I play 14 of the second string. And then do a pull off from 15 to 12. And I do the same thing again, but with a slight bend. Okay, so it'll go. And at the end of that, I go. So do a slight bend on 14, in and out until a pull off to 12. And then I just play 14, 12 on the 4. So let's try this whole little chunk. Little bit at the start. Alright guys, let's take a look at the second section. I want to start off on 5 of the second string and then do a hammer-on from 3 to 5 on the first string. And then from here I pick all the notes. So what I'm doing here is I'm going 7, 6, 5, 3 and then hitting 5 of the second string. So I go. Okay, then from here I go, slow that down. I'm doing a pull off into a hammer, from 5 to 3 back to 5, and then I go to 2 of the first string, so I'll go. I then skip a string to third string on the 4th fret, so I'll go. And I do a pull off from 5 to 3 on the 2nd. So all together. Okay, so all together it goes. And we've just got this bluesy run that follows it, which is this. Something like that. So what I've got here is a pull-off from the third string. I'm going 4-2 open. I do that twice. I don't pick it again, though. So I guess I'm doing that all in one go. So I'm going 4-2 open, hammering to 4, pulling off to 2, and then going to the open note. And then I do a 2 to open, pull off on the 4th string. And I play open on the 3rd. So I do open on the 3rd, do a pull off from 2 to open, and then play 2 with the 5th string. So all together. Okay, and then at the end of that it'll go. So what I've got there is I'm going 2 to open on the 4th, 2 to open on the 5th, and then 3 of the top string, and then it goes to an open note as well. So I go... At the end of that, I've got to bend up and back on 8 of the 1st string. So let's try the whole thing thus far. Okay, the 3rd section we're dealing with some pretty intervallic arpeggios. I'm starting from 3 of the 5th string and then going to 7 of the 4th. And then jumping to 5 of the 2nd string. I do pretty much the same idea up 2 frets, but because of the purpose of the next phrase, I'll attack that note at the bottom with my pointer instead of my middle. So let's try it all thus far. 3, 7, 5 of the 2nd, and then I go 5, 9, and then 7 of the 2nd. Okay, so let's work it from this point now. I'm going to go... What I'm doing here is I'm going 7, 8, 10, and then 7 of the 1st string, so from the 2nd string. Then I go back up to 10 of the 2nd string with my pinky. And then I slide with my middle finger from 8 to 10. And then I go 8, 7 at the end of that. So I'll play it all slowly. All together. Sorry about that slide. And then it goes. This is all just arpeggio kind of stuff. So we're going to go from 10 of the 5th, and we're going to go 10, 14 of the 4th, and then 12 of the 2nd. Then I've got like a basic minor shape here, so sort of a power chord, and then that high note at the bottom. I'm going 12 of the 5th, 14 of the 4th, and then 13 of the 2nd. Next one's a little strange. I'm going 14 of the 5th, 17 of the 4th, and then 15 of the 2nd. Probably my favorite, it's quite nice. I've got two kind of major shapes in a row after that, so working with just a power chord, that kind of high major note there. So I'm going 15 and 17 on the 5th and 4th string, then 17 at the 2nd, and then go 17, 19 with that little power chord on the 5th and 4th string, and then I've got my pinky hitting 19 of the 1st string, sorry, 19 of the 2nd string, and then I hit 15 of the 1st. So the last bit goes... Let's play the second half of that whole section. Alright, let's work it from the start of the whole thing now. Okay, this last section is a little bit strange. I think Eric has... a pick in his hand, and then he sort of... For me, I'm just using my thumb and my pointer, but do as you see fit. It's pretty hard to try crossing those strings like that, so do what you feel comfortable with. I'm starting from 19 of the 2nd string, and then I'm going to 15 of the 1st, and all the notes seem to be coming back to that 15 of the 1st. So we're going 19 of the 2nd string, back to 15 of the 1st, 19 of the 3rd, and then back to the 15. And then I do the same on the 4th string. And then I bring it back to 17 of the 4th string. I go 17 of the 4th, 17 of the 3rd, 17 of the 2nd. And of course, we're always adding in that pointer note in between. So we're going to go... Let's try it all together. Okay, and I just want to do that whole idea twice. I'm just going to sort of do two laps of that little box shape we've created. So we're going to go... Okay, and then after that, I do it again, but the shape's a little bit smaller. So I'm just going to go 19 on the 2nd and the 3rd string, and then 17 on the 3rd and the 2nd string. So it's going to go like this. And that's going to do two laps as well. So that was just 19 of the 2nd, 19 of the 3rd, 17 of the 3rd, 17 of the 2nd. We did two laps of that. So we'll do two of the big shape and two of the little shape. At the end of that second shape, I add in one more 19 of the 2nd string. Okay, after all that's said and done, we go to this little shreddy run to finish it off. squeal. There it is. All right, so what I'm going to do, let's take this slightly. I'm going to go 17, 15, 14 on the first string. And then I go to 19 of the first, and I go 19, 17, 15, and then to 14. So all together. And then 17, 15, 14 again. So we've got that at the start and then the other bit, and then we do it again. Okay, now the next bit, I want to go 15, 13, and then 17, 15, 13. So all together. And the next bit, I play 14, 12 on the second, on the third string. And then from this point on, I want to do this group of five notes three times. So I'm going to go 16, 14, 12 on the third, and then 14, 12 on the fourth string. So it'll go. So just a group of three of those five notes. So all together, we're going to go. One, two, three. And then I want to go to 10 of the fifth string, and then do a squeal on 11 of the third string. A lot of trouble finding that. And with the right amount of reverb, that will sound pretty awesome. So let's try that whole section again a little slower. And there you have it, the intro to Cliffs of Dover. I hope you guys have enjoyed that. I'll catch you soon.